Hi. The work I see to be done. It is the end of May 2010. I felt internal leadings for some years now, some couple of years, and have also been uncomfortable in those past years with the lack of connectivity and groovosity with the locals. I blame them not at all at this moment, and in a high reality, a high truth, a poor me truth, they're fuckers. In the last year or so, more in the last month, I've come to an overwhelming sense of where to stand, what to stand for, how to maintain my stance, and that is the light of decency, the power of goodness, the truth that is. Peeking through the dirt. The seed has been stimulated. Gestation has begun. The light seed of truth, the light seed of love. Source, the spirit of truth has long focused the minute particles of willingness and ability toward purpose, toward the way, towards the heart, towards empathy, unconditional fluidity. Let it go, let love flow. So, I resist though I do not deny the sense of purpose, of mission, of being of use, and the threads of glorification of self, of that's what I resist, but yet stay attentive to, in that it is part of the sensation of the fullness of the experience of being here now in this moment, as I am in what is, as it is particular to this moment. I believe, mainly optimistically, but somewhat experientially in my heart, that people are good. People lean toward goodness more so than towards littleness, towards deceit, towards unwillingness, towards collateral damage. The way to spark our brothers and sisters is to speak the words that are within them, to share the common good and purpose, which is a divine purpose, a beautiful purpose, a human purpose, in reaching out of necessity to stand, accept our ability to respond, even without the blinding thoughtlessness of a long dead story of God. Now, get me not wrong. God I love, the whole shebang, good. I sense that God wants us to do whatever it is within our ability to do, that we may choose with our own will, our own humanity, goodness, that we may be awarded the eternal celebrations, that we may be awarded the eternal celebrations even in the beginning of our journey, where the eternal truth is distant. As far as our ability to perceive, whether Jesus comes as we think he's going to come or not, irrelevant. What's relevant is that we don't have our heads up our ass and miss the boat. Put yourself in God's shoes. Do you want to secure a job for your kid that he has not earned, a position that he is not qualified for, that he may have a comfortable, easy life? Or would you like for him to have the security and the nurturing truth that, right or wrong, sink or swim, we're family. And you've got his back. He can sleep in the basement. Come back home, sleep in the basement for a little bit. It's okay, kid. Go for it again. For now.